Now, one more NPC and then we go talk to the Emerald Herald. And there's a message over there. Message! Ah, god, I'm sorry for my pronunciation. Pick up item. Soul, a nameless soldier, and a life gem. I should eat all those souls so I can level up with the strength since I wanna, wield that morning star. Now right here is the blue crescent warrior. Blue sentinel warrior, I don't remember. He is basically the same as that warrior, that dig warrior from Dark Souls 1 and Demon Souls. The blue armored warrior. They be a dick and stuff. But this guy, he's actually a pretty kind guy. He's a pretty nice dude.
You're undead, aren't you? You have that distinct scent. The smell of irreversible fate. This is Majula. It is a kind of settlement. A place where life is almost normal. And in Drang Lake these days, there are very few places like that. I am Solden. And like you, I lost everything. And now I'm here. You probably heard that it was possible to break the curse here. Well, that's not true at all. There's nothing here for you, me, or anybody.
This dude is really pessimistic and I pity him. I feel very bad for him. But he's actually much more humble and not a dick than the other two Crescent Warriors from the last Souls game. Last two Souls game. Excuse me. Oh god, so unprofessional.
Do you know much about souls? Even I'm not certain, but I'm told that the soul is the essence of life itself. Anything living, sentient or no, supposedly has one. What we call the curse is traceable to the soul. Do you see what that means? To be alive. To walk this earth. That's the real curse, right there. We undead will never die. And that's quite a predicament, really. There are four beings in this land with giant souls. And wherever you go from here, you'll sooner or later come up against them. Each has a powerful soul, and a terrible curse. If that frightens you, then you ought to just give up right now, like I have.
Okay, that one dialogue kinda, you know, make him look like a dick, but meh.
Do you ever cry out for help? The journey of an undead is long and treacherous. You'll face invaders from other worlds at every turn. If you need help, why not proclaim faith in the Blue Sentinels? When you face danger, the Blue Sentinels will come to your aid. Protection is yours, if you wish. You need only accept their kind embrace. I see. Then you'll have to brave this treacherous journey on your own. If you ever require help, come back anytime. I will stay here and pray for your safety.
So if you ever want to join the Way of Blue Covenant, which is a covenant whenever you get invaded by an annoying PvP player which is uninvited to your world, you can always wear the ring he will give you, and Blue Sentinels player will automatically summon to your world and defeat the PvP players, the Red Phantom players. Now what's over here? So an ancient king sealed away the shrine of winter. Okay. Is there any other message? It's the same thing. Whoa, that's a lot of deaths. Worldwide, too. Now, our last NPC before we end this session is to talk to the Emerald Herald and then rest at the bonfire. Oh, wait, 1 second. Let's use Old Soul. Boom. I hope that's enough for a level up.
Are you the next monarch? Or merely a pawn of fate? Bearer of the curse. I will remain by your side till this frail hope shatters. Take this with you. May it ease your journey.
Essence Flask. Yep.
Go on and see the king. He who made Drangleic what it once was. He who peered at the essence of the soul. King Vendrick.
You may level up by the power of the Emerald Herald.
Bearer of the curse, seek misery. For misery will lead you to greater, stronger souls. You will never meet the king with a soul so frail and pallid.
Hey.
Seek those whose names are unutterable. The four endowed with immense souls. Their souls will serve as beacons. Once you have found them, return here to me, so that hope will not fade away.
I apologize for that. There was a Facebook message. Damn it. I apologize for that. That was so unprofessional. Wait 1 second. Alright, I apologize for that again. That was so unprofessional of me. And let's get back to the dialogue.
Is that a shard you found? Here, let me see it, so that I may help you to see light, to see hope, however faint it might be.
Alright, upgrade Estus Flash Shard. And we got an extra Estus Flask. Well, let's level up and see if I can. Just one. Let's level up our Faith first, because that's very important for our Faith Strength build character. Sleeve. Alright, so I guess that's it for this session. And next time we'll be back, we will go towards the Forest of the Giants and fight our first boss, which is the last giant. And go through all those weird, creepy undead shit. Not that they're not really that creepy. Oh, that guy looks cool. They're not really that creepy, but still. I've got nothing to say anymore. But after that, we would go. I think we would go fight the Pursuer. Since Pursuer is optional, but I would like to have his ring, which is really good. So I guess that's it. Now, thank you for watching. Now please leave a like and comment. And if you want more content of Dark Souls 2, well, I don't just do Dark Souls 2 gameplay. I do other stuff, but this is the only thing I do right now since I'm busy with school. So yeah, thank you for watching. My name is RollTDN, aka Eru, and bye.